So iPhones have had a solid reputation for their CPU performance for ages. Apple got so cocky about it that they even started poking fun at Snapdragon chips during their events. While Android phones have made substantial strides in graphics performance in recent years, when it comes to CPU performance, Apple has remained at the top of the game. However, the status quo is now undergoing a transformation with the Galaxy S24 Ultra and the Snapdragon 8 Gen 3. Just a couple of days ago, Qualcomm dropped this new chip that's loaded with generative AI features and some serious performance upgrades. I even made a video about it. If you're interested, you can check out the link down below. And today, Qualcomm has revealed the official benchmark scores of the 8 Gen 3. And let me tell you, the numbers blew me away. As you can see on Geekbench 6, it scores 7,500 points in multi-core, almost 270 more than the iPhone 15 Pro Max, which has the A17 Pro chip. It's the first time in more than a decade that a Snapdragon chip has better multi-core scores on Geekbench than Apple's A-series chip, which is huge. And remember, Geekbench isn't exactly optimized for Android, but the 8 Gen 3 still managed to beat Apple's best in multi-core performance. Plus, it's still a 4-nanometer chip, while the A17 Pro plays with a better 3-nanometer tech, making this feat even more impressive. On single core, however, the iPhone 15 Pro Max is still better. Now coming to the Antutu benchmark, which checks both CPU and GPU. The Snapdragon 8 Gen 3 straight up outperforms the A17 Pro with a whopping 44% higher score. When it comes to pure GPU tests, like the famous 3DMark wildlife test, the 8 Gen 3 leaves the A17 Pro in the dust with a massive 31% higher score. Now you might be wondering about efficiency because, let's be real, battery life is a big deal for most of us. Well, here's the scoop. The 8 Gen 3 is more efficient than the A17 Pro. The results show that the A17 Pro's GPU peaks at 10.9 watts, whereas the Adreno GPU scores higher while consuming less power at just 8.2 watts. So basically, the 8 Gen 3 chip not only performs better than Apple's latest in both CPU and GPU, but it does that while consuming less power. That means the battery life on the Galaxy S24 Ultra is likely to outlast the iPhone 15 Pro Max. Samsung is also using an overclocked version of the 8 Gen 3, so the performance gap between the S24 Ultra and the 15 Pro Max is gonna be even wider. Now you might be wondering, why do we even need all this power? I mean, phones are already blazing fast, right? Well, a couple of months ago, I'd probably agree, but not anymore. You see, generative AI is the next big thing, and it's already here. You can now do stuff with your phone which was not imaginable just a year ago. I mean, take for example the object eraser for videos. Right now, you need to spend hours on After Effects to remove something from a video, and you need to have the skill to use the software. But with the S24 Ultra, you can do that with just a tap of a button. But you see, generative AI needs a lot of processing power and memory, and this is where all these huge gains will come into play, so that you don't end up staring at your screen for ages for AI to do its processing. With that said, you can find some of these generative AI features we're getting on the S24 Ultra here, and I'll see you there.